Hello everybody. In this tutorial, we shall talk about timer in TwinCAD environment. We shall cover, what is a timer? How to use a timer in structured text? There are a few types of timers and function blocks in structured text. Among these, we shall talk about and use TON and our trig in this tutorial. In this tutorial, we shall increase a number by 1 every 100 milliseconds. When the value reaches 20, then we reset its value to 0. We shall have another variable that will count how many times it has reached 20. This will be achieved by our trig. The integer counter goes from 0 to 20 and 20 counter increases as we count as shown in the image. Let's start the implementation. As we see, we have created empty PLC program. Now we shall add the necessary variables. We shall declare a variable start timer of Boolean type and initialize to false. If this is true, then the timer starts, and if it is false, the timer stops. When the timer output Q value is true, it means it has elapsed 100 milliseconds. Then we increase the counter by 1. The variable name will be integer counter. We declare the variable integer counter and its type is integer. We initialize the variable to 0. In each 100 milliseconds, integer counter will be increased by 1, and when it reaches to 20, then it resets to 0. Then we use another integer type variable that is called 20 counter. Let's declare a variable 20 counter and initialized it to 0. We shall use our trig timer to count 20 counter. This variable tells how many times integer counter has been 0 to 20. Then we have to declare two timers. This is good opportunity to learn about these two timers. As we have said, TON will be used to count the integer counter. Now we declare a variable myTimer and its type is TON. And our trig will be used to count the 20 counter. We declare a variable myRTrig and type is our trig. It has one input clock and one output Q. As soon as clock returns true, Q will return true. When the integer counter is 20, then we activate this our trig. Now we shall initialize myTimer. MyTimer's input in will be initialized with the startTimer variable. If startTimer is true, then this timer will start. If startTimer is false, then the timer will stop. We assign the start timer to the input of my timer. If start timer is true, then in the same PLC cycle in will be true. Start timer can be set to true by Visual Studio or by an HMI. Then we have another input variable which is PT of time type. We initialize PT to 100 milliseconds. PT will be assigned as T hashtag 100 ms. Ms means milliseconds. If we have 100 minutes, then we write T hashtag 100m. If start timer is true, then after 100 milliseconds, the output Q will be true. So we check each PLC cycle when the Q is true by if statement. If the output Q is true, then it has elapsed 100 milliseconds. Then we can increase the integer counter by 1. We put a if statement and then followed by end if. We read the current integer counter value and add 1 to it, inside the if block. We also set the input of myTimer to false for a cycle. In this way, it will continue counting until we set the start timer to false. This will give an option for myTimer to stop for a PLC cycle. But the myTimer will start again since we are keeping the start timer to true. We assign myTimer's an input to false. So the timer will be off for a cycle. And in next cycle, timer will start counting until the output Q is true. Inside the if statement, we read the start counter and add 1 to it. When the timer elapsed, then we can do other necessary stuff based on our requirements. Each loop when Q is true, integer counter is increased. So we type integer counter equal to integer counter plus 1. Next, we check if the integer counter is greater than 20 by if block. If integer counter is greater than 20, then we reset the integer counter to 0. Each PLC cycle, we check all these conditions. In some PLC cycle, integer counter will be 20. If integer counter is greater than 20, then we reset to 0. So we reassign the integer counter to 0. Now we are done with TON timer. At this point, in our code, we have two if and two end if. Now we shall use our trig. Our trig is a trigger which can be used to trigger something. Our trig has one input and one output. Input variable is clock and its type is Boolean. Output variable is Q and its type is Boolean as well. We shall not assign directly to the clock, but we assign the comparison result. We compare integer counter and 20, then we assign the result to the clock. So the trigger will be activated only when the integer counter is 20. We initialize clock to the comparison result of integer counter equals 20. The comparison result is Boolean type, so it can be easily assigned to clock. By this, we are telling myrtrig when integer counter is 20, then activate the trigger. If the clock is true, then the output Q will be true as well. So we need to start checking the output when Q will be high. The output of myrtrig will be true when integer counter is 20, in other case, output of myrtrig will be false. We can use another if statement, the output of our trig is true. Let's introduce another if end if block. Now we can increase 20 counter by 1. When Q is true, then 20 counter will be increased. For details text version, please check at hemilix.com. You can find this sample for download also. Also, we can check at infosys.com page. Inside the if block we type 20 counter equal 20 counter plus 1. We shall not reset 20 counter, so it will increase indefinitely. So this is all about our implementation. Save and build the project. Also, we need to check the real-time settings. If all are okay, we can activate the program. Activate means we download the program to runtime. We can log into the PLC program. We can update variables via Visual Studio. We change the start timer to true. Whenever we have set it to true, timer will start. Expand the my timer for checking ET and Q. See how those are changed. See that integer counter is increasing, and when it reaches 20, then it reset to 0. See also that 20 counter is increasing each time when integer counter is 20. Also, note that the ET of my timer is going from 0 to 100 milliseconds, with 10 millisecond step. And it is repeating. Now let's take a closer look how it is working. Go to the PLC timer page, we have some diagram that will help to understand it. By the way, you can download this sample from the same page. PLC cycle time is the time when PLC program starts and when the program ends. This includes some housekeeping work as well. Typically PLC program reads the inputs, execute the program and then output the program. This will be repeated until we change the PLC mode, for example to run mode. Roughly we can say PLC scan mean from the start scanning arrow to end scanning arrow. So in each scan, it will check all the variables and make decision based on these. So this will repeat all the time and very fast. And do the input output. Some people express the PLC cycle by a circular diagram as in the middle picture, and others by a linear diagram. Both are the same. As we see, both diagram are showing similar information. Read, analyze, and do output. Now let's compare our PLC program with the timing diagram. The first diagram is timing diagram. First in is false, when we set start timer to true, it becomes true. Since we have a constant interval of 100 milliseconds, the in diagram will be uniform in shape. After PT time, Q will be true. In our case, PT is 100 milliseconds. X-axis is time and Y-axis is value of signals. Imagine a vertical line when in goes false to true. ET will start counting when in is true. ET will have a value of PT when the Q becomes true. We set the input of the TON timer to false, so in the next cycle, the timer will start again. You can change the time PT to something bigger to test it. I use smaller values for quick data. Then we are setting it to false. So setting it to false means, in next cycle the in will be true. It will go up and it is continuing in this way, and if we don't change the start timer to false. If we don't set my timer to false when Q has been true for all the time, and my timer will not get a chance to restart again. So in goes true and false, and we can continue counting our number. We can test by commenting my timer, line number 4. It means that timer output Q will be true all the way, and then it will not have a chance to restart that timer. So this is important that we set it to false. If we examine the in signal, when it becomes true we call it rising edge, and when it goes false we set falling edge. Many times, we need to detect the edge, but in our sample we are ignoring these. You can download the sample from hemilix.com and load it with your Visual Studio. Change the different values and compare them. You will become a master of how to use timers in structured text. Now let's log into the program to check what it is doing. If we take a closer look, we can see ET is changing from 0 to 100 milliseconds with 10 milliseconds interval. We have some values to 20 counter and that is growing. Integer counter is changing between 0 and 20. We can change the value of the PT and see how often it increase the counter. We can get more information from Infosys and well as from Hemlix.com. We have many others HMI and PLC sample at Hemlix.com. If you like our works, then share it in your network. And subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.